Yeah, I tried it. I figured we'd start with that.
Okay, great. I love it.
Yeah, don't mess it up, man. We'll have to change it to somebody
it's all,
else.
Yeah,
we could change it to Chris's groove.
Yeah, Kendall's groove.
You'll Kendall's the album. Ooh.
McCurdy is like one of the greatest jazz drummers that ever lived. I mean, he played with Sonny Rollins, Cannonball Adderley, and all these people. So we always used to play the Jimmy Smith song, Chicken Shack. And every time we play that tune, people get up and start dancing and all. But nobody plays that groove like Roy. So I wrote this tune, and I just put Roy's groove on there as kind of like just a working title, right? So I brought it to rehearsal, and Roy plays it. And we played it, you know, and I said, yeah, Roy, you know, I called it Roy's Groove. I said, but that's just the working title. He goes, oh, no, man, that's the title. And it's an honor to play with him. I mean, the guy is, like, astounding. He's, like, going to be 80 years old this year. The guy looks like he's 60. We were at a gig one time, and somebody turned to me and said, Is that Roy McCurdy's roadie? I said, no, that's Roy McCurdy carrying his own drums. He goes, you gotta be kidding me. This is when Roy was in his 70s. He's just an astounding human being, man. And a lovely guy, you know, great musician. Nobody plays that groove like Roy. I mean, I played that song with numerous other drummers and everybody, but that's just his, he's got that groove. That's his thing.
Take a listen to something, or
that's the groove. Ow! Yeah, guys.
Yeah,
that was
a good one.
So, seeing Roy's groove as a working title, what do you think would be a good title for this song?
Yeah.